It's just like old times, seeing you play with Amanda again. You don't know how much I've missed that.
Mac, we have to talk.
Hello, Blaine.
Why are you here, Mr. Colton?
Well, I came to see you, actually.
Don't you think my attorney should be present if you're going to talk to me?
Well, no, I don't think that's necessary in this case. Actually, I came by as the bearer of some good news.
Come in.
Yeah, Jerry brought them over this morning.
Should be no problem getting an enlargement, is it?
Yeah, hope so. Is there anything I can help with?
No, not really.
Hmm. You mind if I stick around?
No, as a matter of fact, you could show me what areas you want me to concentrate on.
Oh, yeah, let me have.
No fingerprints.
Right. Why don't we start in this area right here.
And now, the continuing story of Another World.
I know what you want to talk about, but I really don't think there's anything more that we can say to each other about that.
Well, I think there is. I don't want to lose Amanda, Mac.
You should have thought of that before you walked out of here with Blake.
I want her, Mac.
I'm sorry, Rachel. You're not going to have her as long as you live with that man.
She misses me.
I'm sure she does, and I'm sure it's terribly difficult for you knowing that there is no one else that you can blame but yourself.
How can you be so self-righteous to me after what you've done? Hiring a detective to follow me and report back to you? Are you proud of that?
No, I'm not proud of it.
But you're going to use the information if you have to, wouldn't you?
Yes, I certainly would. As repulsive as this whole business is to me, I will use anything I can get my hands on so you can't take my daughter from me. I told you that from the beginning, Rachel.
All right, well, you go ahead. You do anything you can. But detective or no, nobody's going to prove I'm an unfit mother for her.
But can you prove that you can support her?
Of course I can.
You mean from the gallery?
Yes.
Rachel, it takes time to establish a business, to make it pay.
I know that. We're not exactly without money. I mean, I'm teaching, and Mitch is doing some work at the Connection.
Well, yes, I'm sure you can survive, even support him. But that doesn't compare in any way to what I can do for Amanda's future. Now, do you really want to deprive your daughter of all the advantages that I can give her?
Don't do this, Mac. Don't hold up your wealth against my love for my daughter.
And that's something else you're forgetting, Rachel.
What?
I love her just as much as you do. And I intend to keep her.
So, you have some good news for me.
That's right.
Well, I think the only good news I'd really like to hear is to hear that you're dropping the charges against me.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. It isn't quite that sensational, but it is good news, nevertheless.
What is it?
Well, I happened to be in the old records a while ago, and I was looking out. I found something very interesting there.
In the Hall of Records?
Yeah. You know, that's where they record births, deaths, marriages, and titles of property, right? So I thought I would check up on the title to the old Iris Carrington house, the one where you and Jordan live. And
what for?
Well, just curiosity. Anyway, I found out that now that Jordan is gone, you've become the sole owner of that property.
I do?
Yeah. What, does that surprise you?
Well, yes, I thought...
What?
Nothing.
So, you know, if you choose to sell it or whatever, you stand to become quite a wealthy young lady.
Thank you, but I really think that's the least of my problems right now.
Well, I wouldn't really call it a problem, would you? Blaine, I know you'd be more pleased if I told you that we came up with that little black book.
Did you find it?
No, unfortunately. I mean, not a trace of it. If it does exist.
It exists, I know. I held it in my hands.
Well, I know that's what you keep saying, but so far we haven't been able to turn up a thing. Now, Blaine, supposing, just for the sake of argument, that the book does exist, do you have any idea what kind of things Jordan has written down in that book?
Pardon me, I'll be right back.
Colton, what are you doing?
Just calm down, counselor. This is purely a social call.
I find that hard to believe.
Well, I brought your client some good news.
All right, Colton, if you've delivered your news, and would you excuse us? I have a number of things to discuss with my client.
All right, I'm sure you have. Well, I'll be on my way. Thank you, Blaine. Good day.
Sally, can I see you for a minute? Hi.
Wanted to see me?
Yeah. What are you doing at noon today?
Well, nothing really.
Okay, I have to go home because I left some work there. I have to pick it up. And I was wondering if you'd like to come with me.
Well, sure.
Yeah, I know that you're thinking about getting your own apartment, so I thought you'd like to see mine.
Oh, that'd be great.
Good. Then I'll tell you when I'm ready to leave.
Okay.
Sally.
Yeah?
Would you do me a favor?
Anything?
Would you mind taking that cup of coffee into Jamie? He left it here a few minutes ago.
Okay, sure. Do you want me to pour this out?
No. I just put some fresh coffee in it. Just take it to him and tell him to drink it before it gets too cold. He has a big meeting with Mac and Philip Lyons today, and he's going to need that.
Okay.
Thank you, Sally.
You're welcome.
Well, they're sharp shooting pains through here.
I see.
What are you thinking, Olivia?
Well, that it might have something to do with your fatigue level. Are you feeling pain now?
No.
Okay. No pain at all?
No.
All right, Marianne, I think what we should do is just keep a close eye on what's happening to you. If you get any pain at all, I want you to come right in and see me, and don't ignore them. We may have to just keep you off your feet for a few days.
Thanks, Olivia.
Now, you just take good care of yourself, all right?
I will. There is one thing you could do for me.
What's that?
Please don't mention any of this to Rick.
Well, why not?
Oh, well, you know Rick. He's the world's worst worrywart, and I just don't want him getting concerned, especially if it's nothing.
Okay, but you come see me if you have any pain.
You'll be the first to know.
And why was Colton here, Blaine?
It's really nothing very important.
Now, you let me decide that. I'd like to know why he was here.
Well, he came to tell me that the old Iris Carrington house belongs to me now.
Well, how did he find out about this?
He was at the Hall of Records and he checked.
I see. And did he say why he checked it?
Just curious. You don't think there's anything wrong with that, do you?
I don't know.
Well, it just means that if I survive the trial, then I'll have some money.
Yes.
Brian, what's the matter?
I'm just wondering what the real reason for Colton's visit.
Well, I don't think he had any ulterior motive.
Well, don't be too sure about that, because Zachary Colton never does anything without a reason.
But don't you think it was very thoughtful of him to come by and tell me that I do get the money from the house now that Jordan's dead?
Don't underestimate him, Blaine. It's true, the house will provide you with money. But Colton may also have some other reason in mind.
What?
Proving that the money will provide you with a very good motive for murder.
Going to be able to make it this afternoon.
Well, how come?
I have something to do.
What?
Well, Cecile asked me to go over to her apartment with her to pick up something. Oh, Leigh, I'm so excited. I've been dying to see where she lives, and now's my chance.
But I thought we were supposed to have a special lunch together.
I know, but we can...
I have everything set up.
Look, Leigh, I'm sure it's just wonderful, but this is really very important to me.
Yeah, well, this lunch was important to me, too.
More romantic anyway. You understand why I have to do this, don't you?
Well, yeah.
Thank you, Leigh. You're not upset with me, are you?
No. I was just looking forward to seeing you and doing something special for you.
Well, you can do that tonight, right?
Yeah.
And you know what? Maybe I can get the rest of the afternoon off, and that way we can spend all afternoon and all evening together. And then you could pick me up from Cecile's. How does that sound?
Sounds fine. You think she'll go for it?
I don't see why not. I finished everything around here.
What time are you going to want me to pick you up?
I don't know yet. I'll give you a call, though, okay?
All right.
Okay. See you later. Bye. Thanks a lot, Cecile, for letting me have the afternoon off.
Oh, nothing much was happening anyway, as long as you're caught up in your work.
Oh, I am. I finished everything before we left the office.
Good, then there's no problem.
And you don't mind my waiting here to be picked up?
No, not at all, as long as you lock the door behind you.
Okay, thanks a lot. Oh, boy. Oh, this is wonderful.
Oh, I'm glad you like it.
The most beautiful place I've ever seen.
There are better places, my dear.
Oh, I find that hard to believe.
For an apartment, it's okay.
Do you mind if I...
No, go ahead.
Oh, this is absolutely perfect.
Yeah, I used to think that before I was married, but now...
What?
Well, now that Jamie and I are married, I think that we should buy a house.
Oh, does Jamie want a house, too?
Well, we haven't talked about it too much, but I think he will.
Have you seen any you liked?
I don't have to look. I know the exact house that I want.
You do?
Mm-hmm. The Iris Carrington house.
That's not exactly a house. That is a mansion.
Oh, but it's so nice, isn't it?
Yeah, it is beautiful.
But Jamie and I, we announced our marriage there.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, how romantic.
Yeah, it was.
You know, I didn't think the Carrington Mansion was for sale.
Well, it's not right now, but it may be shortly.
You know, you're not much older than I am, but you have everything. How did you get so far so fast?
Oh, that's not difficult. All you have to do is decide what it is you want, and then go get it.
Olivia, have you seen Rick today?
No, is he on duty?
Well, no, he's not scheduled, but that never stops him. The trouble with this guy is keeping him out of the hospital, not in it.
I know. He really is dedicated, isn't he?
Yeah, perhaps he's a little too dedicated. Oh, I have an idea, though.
You, an idea? What is it?
Don't be too surprised. I get him once in a while. Well, Rick mentioned something about working on the Blaine Ewing case with Mitch Blake.
Mitch Blake? And how did that unlikely pairing come about?
Well, Jerry Grove. Mm-hmm. Had asked Rick to look into the Jordan Scott killing. And Rick apparently came up with something that didn't seem quite right to him. As he was going through the police files, he came up with these photographs of the murder scene. Huh. One of them had an object in it that the other one didn't. So he and Jerry decided that they would ask Mitch to enlarge the photographs, see if they could identify what it was. That's probably where he is right now.
You know something?
What?
You're beginning to sound like the proudest father telling up all the daring do exploits of his favorite son. You
come
are.
Come on, do I?
Yes, you do.
Well, I guess I do feel close to Rick. I know how he operates. When he gets something in his head, he doesn't let go.
What do you think? Still can't make it out. Think we can get it larger?
Sure.
Do you want to do it?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right. Same area, huh?
Okay.
What, Rachel? Everything that Mac is doing is detective stuff. It's like something out of a cheap paperback novel.
Rachel, look, will you please calm down and tell me what's happening? You're not making any sense.
Mac is trying to discredit me as Amanda's mother.
Rachel, will you please light someplace?
I'm too angry.
Look, either you settle down or you talk to somebody else, because I'm not going to follow you around this room trying to find out what you're talking about.
I can't believe that he's doing this to me.
Look, Rachel, calm down and tell me exactly what Mac said.
He's going to use this detective's report against me and Mitch.
Does that surprise you?
Yes, it surprises me. It surprises me that he'd hire the detective in the first place, and it surprises me that he'd use the report against us.
Well, sure he's going to use it. The man isn't a fool, Rachel. I mean, he wants that child as much as you do. And he's doing no more than you would to keep her.
I would never hire anybody to spy on him.
Oh, you wouldn't?
Well, what does that mean?
If you could afford it, and you were trying to win Amanda's custody, wouldn't you be doing the same thing?
And now he's using his wealth against me, too.
How?
He wants to tell the court that he can provide more for Amanda than I can.
Well, it's true. He can.
He's talking about material things, not love. Mitch and I can provide just as much love for Amanda as he can.
Rachel, look, I know that you love Amanda. But Mac has got a lot of money.
And I don't. You're beginning to sound just like him. He flaunted his wealth to me. He said I would never be able to provide for her. And then he put down the gallery as though it was some sort of toy that shouldn't be taken seriously.
Well, you gotta admit, an art gallery isn't exactly a sure thing.
The only sure thing in this town is the Corey complex. And what do you think my chances are of getting a job there?
Rachel, look, no matter how talented you and Mitch are, it's gonna be a while before you make any money.
So just because we're trying to start something new, a new business that we believe in, we're not supposed to have custody of my daughter?
Well, no, that's not what I'm saying, but you just have to look at this realistically.
I am.
You're not looking at it like the court will.
And how is that?
With the evidence that Mac has against you and your relationship with Mitch and the life he can provide for Amanda, the court could decide that it would be in Amanda's best interest to stay with Mac.
Well, I'll fight it.
Well, I don't think that money is the whole issue.
Well, then what is?
Your relationship with Mitch Blake.
Well, for all intents and purposes, this should prove the relationship between your wife and Blake. I'd say the file is rather complete. You've done a very thorough job.
Thank you. We're not through yet, though. There's still a few things to check out.
Well, of course, that depends entirely on Mr. Corey here.
This will count very heavily against Rachel, woman.
Most likely. The courts tend to frown on anything that might be considered sexual promiscuity.
What more can be done?
Well, as I've told you before, Blake's been working at the Connection. The place is owned by Jess Cooper and his people, and they've got connections with some pretty heavy criminal elements.
How's this information going to help my case?
Well, I've got my partner all set to apply for a job at the Connection. He can keep his eye on Blake and see just how closely tied to Jess Cooper and his people he really is.
What do you say, Mr. Bonner?
Well, I think it would be very important. If Mr. Blake is connected with these underworld elements, it could prove his undesirability as a prospective parent for your child.
All right, go ahead.
Okay, I'll get right on it.
Well, I think it's a very smart decision, Mr. Corey. It'll help to have as much on our side as possible.
Jamie, where were you during lunch, honey? I was looking for you.
I had to find this file. Oh, yeah, would you look through it, see if you can find a substitute for that article that you edited for the August Bravo?
Sure, I will.
Cecile, I don't know what's wrong with me.
What do you mean?
Well, I keep yawning. I can't seem to keep my eyes open. I'm real sleepy.
Honey, you really have to be awake for that meeting today with Mac and Philip.
Yeah, I know.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I can handle it.
Okay. Maybe what you need is another cup of coffee, huh?
Yeah, thanks.
Oh, I'm sorry, sweetie. It's empty.
Oh, that's okay. Give me the cup. I'll have Liz a cup.
Oh, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll make another pot, and I'll bring the cup into you.
Oh, okay, thanks.
All right. Jamie, please wake up. That meeting is so important.
I know.
Thank you.
Marianne. Can we talk? If you want. Please. I know that you had an appointment with Dr. Delaney this morning. Are you all right? I'm fine. Marianne, I just want you to know how I feel.
Kit, I think you've made it very clear how you feel.
No, I don't think I have. In spite of what I said to you about what Cecile told me, I want you to know that I want only happiness for you and Rick and your child.
I believe you, Kit. And I talked to Jamie about what you told me, and he's dealt with Cecile. So I really don't want to talk about it anymore.
Marianne, I want you to know I'm sorry. And I care about you as well as Rick.
I care about Rick, too.
I am sorry.
It's all right. We have to stop meeting like this. Now, I have a question for you.
Sure.
I couldn't help but notice that Jerry hasn't been around lately.
No. No, he hasn't.
Did something happen?
Yeah, that's the problem.
What do you mean?
Nothing happened. I mean, we should have been in love, and nothing happened.
But I thought you were...
Yeah, so did I. But I guess there's only room for one woman in Jerry's life right now, and that's Blaine.
Mountain is so high, I can't make it all on my own. No, rolling river, why so wide? Sweep me up and bear me on. Up against the sky so bright that I can't even close my eyes. I know I'll follow.
Cecile here?
Nobody's here.
Well, then I don't think I'd better, Sally.
Come on in. Don't be silly. Come on. Isn't it beautiful?
Yeah, it's all right.
All right? Leigh, this is absolutely wonderful.
Well, it's real gray, you know? Kind of cold.
I don't know how you can say that. This is the most beautiful apartment I have ever seen. And I want to live like this someday.
I thought you liked my apartment.
Well, I do, but I was thinking of that as more of like a temporary thing, you know?
Temporary?
Yeah.
I certainly don't plan on moving again soon, Sally.
You're gonna stay there?
Yeah. I mean, it's okay for me for now.
But don't you think it would be kind of nice if we had an apartment like this? You know, Cecile told me that if you want something bad enough, that there's always a way of getting it.
Alleged circulation is up 18% over last month, and it still shows signs of continuing growth. Now, by comparison to the Sentinel, I think that we're gaining headway, and I estimate by the end of the year, we still might be surpassing them by volume.
That's terrific, Bill. Thank you very much. In fact, I want to thank all of you. This meeting has been very, very heartening to me. I'm just really amazed that we could recover so quickly from the explosion. I want to congratulate each one of you for doing a superb job. So now, unless there's some other business that needs tending to, Jamie, do you have anything to add?
What?
I ask if you had anything to add.
No, nothing.
Well, in that case, I think we can say the meeting is adjourned. Thank you very much,
Adam.
And we can check.
I can't seem to keep my eyes open. I'm real sleepy. Philip, I'm not taking anything.
I didn't mean that.
Good afternoon, gentlemen.
Good afternoon.
Jamie, if you'd stay behind, I'd like to speak to you a minute.
Well, I'll see you later tonight.
Right. Thanks again, Philip. Beautiful job. Would you mind closing the door, please, Jamie?
What do you want to talk to me about?
Come on, sit down, Jamie. Yeah.
Thank you.
Jamie, I couldn't help noticing that you were having trouble staying awake during the meeting. You weren't really following what was going on. And you were unable to answer even the simpler questions put to you.
I'm sorry. I don't know what's wrong. I'm having trouble keeping my eyes open.
Didn't get enough sleep last night?
No, I had plenty. That's why. Mac, I don't understand what's happening to me.
Look, Jamie. You know, I don't want to pry into your personal life, and normally I just wouldn't say anything. But when your personal problems start affecting your work here...
What?
Well, Sandy told me that Cecile came over to the house to see me, and...
And?
And about her bruise, and that she was terribly frightened.
Well, she fell. She hit herself on a door. It was just an accident. She said as much to Sandy. I mean, I wouldn't think of that.
Well, I don't want to think about it at all. And I don't want to talk about it. But when your personal problems beginning to affect your work performance, I just really don't have any choice, Jamie.
What are you getting at?
I don't want to put you down. I do have to tell you, you simply cannot allow your personal life or your personal problems to affect your function here.
Mac, I'm not taking drugs, if that's what
you
think.
No, Jamie.
Really, Mac, I'm not. This thing with Cecile, it was just an accident. Mac, I would never think of...
Listen. I don't want to hear about it. You do not owe me an explanation. Now, look. I've got to go now. I've got people waiting for a meeting. If you do want to talk about it later, I'll be here. All right?
Yeah, sure.
So Rick and I went over to Mitch Blake's to find out if he could blow up the pictures, but he said that they weren't clear enough to enlarge. So this morning, I went over to the police station and got the negatives. Rick is with...
When the police get this book, Jordan, you're never going to be able to hurt me again. Not me or anybody else.
And how do you intend to get it out of the house? How do you intend to get it past me? Oh, Blaine. Well, I guess we're just going to have to discuss this a little more.
Stay where you are. Or I'll shoot you.
No, you won't.
Yes, I will. Get the book. Put it on the sofa.
I don't think so. You want it? Come get it.
I'll shoot you. I swear, Jordan, I will.
Go ahead.
Don't
shoot. I didn't think
Stay
you could
where you
do
are.
It. Come on, Blaine. Give me the gun.
I mean it. I'll do it. I mean it.
Give me the gun, Blaine, and we'll pretend that none of this ever happened. Huh?
Hey, are you all right, Blaine?
Jerry, I guess I was thinking of that Sandy, I bet.
Yeah, look, I'll get it.
Hello. Is this the place for a reunion of three people on the run, right?
Well, look, I'll check it out. Think there's something happening tonight?
Hey, what happened? Here, I'll have to clean this up. Is there something wrong?
Yeah, kind of.
What do you mean, kind of?
The trial date was moved up.
To when?
Tomorrow, Sandy.
I think we're getting it now. I can see it.
It's a bottle.
There's some writing on it, but I can't make it out. Try that. Still too small. We can't make it any bigger.
If you make it bigger, you might lose some definition, but you can try if you want.
Why not? When did you find out about the trial date being moved up?
Several days ago.
Well, why didn't you tell me when you saw me the other day?
She probably knew that I was going to try to get it postponed.
So what happened?
Well, I didn't get it. It's like I didn't get the court order for the autopsy.
Oh, Jerry, come on. You did the best you could.
For all the good of you.
So it doesn't exactly give you much time to put your case together, does it?
No, but there might still be a way that we can beat this thing.
How? What?
Well, we're on to something that we think might help clear Blaine.
What?
Rick thinks that there's a discrepancy in the length of time that it took for Jordan to die.
Yeah? So?
Well, he really hasn't said what it is. But when he went and checked the official police file, he found something that was very strange.
What?
Well, there were two photographs in the file. Now, in one of them, there was something laying next to the body, but it wasn't in the other one.
So?
Well, the photographs were taken a very short time apart. So someone must have picked up whatever that was.
Well, what was it?
Well, we don't know for sure. Rick is over at Mitch Blake's now trying to get the photograph enlarged so we can find out.
So now, wait a second. What this means is that someone would have come onto the scene of the crime after Blaine left, right?
Well, we don't know yet, but we're going to have to wait and see.
Well, when will you know?
Oh, I hope sometime this evening.
You know, it was bad enough when we were on the run with Jordan's men chasing us. And now, even after Jordan's dead, it's still not over.
I know what you mean.
Well, there it is.
The bottle is a vial.
Kind containing liquid medication for injection.
Is that important?
Well, Jordan Scott is taking something himself. Maybe not, but if not, could be.
I still can't read what this label is.
But there might be enough there to pin down what it was.
And then what?
Well, if this didn't belong to Jordan Scott, then we find out who it did belong to. And then hopefully we can find out what connection it had with his murder.
Connection?
There's got to be some. There just has to be.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Another World.